pick Ultra Combo Double, by the way, if you didn't already. It doesn't matter that much because Akuma, okay, like, has no way of landing his ultras. But it's good to practice what there is for both ultras. Let's see here. Oh, yes, yeah, a sick Akuma outfit. So cool. I love this one. Hold on while I marvel a little bit. So we're going to do this like a tutorial. So we're going to start from the absolute bottom of the... We're going to assume that the person who's watching this knows absolutely nothing. And I understand that you know a little bit more than nothing. But, you know, bear with me. So, where do we start with Akuma? That's pretty cool. let me get some meters on the screen before we do anything.
Okay.
That's a good one. I have that one too. Alright, so standing normals, I guess, where we'll start. Stand jab, it's 3 frames. Crouch jab, it's 3 frames. He jabs a lot. Jab is like the fundamental combo tool of this game, and Shoto jab is one of the better ones. His close jab is kind of useless, so you'll usually be going for the crouch one, which doesn't have a close variation. Far strong, I think it cancels. No, it doesn't. I don't quite know what it's for. It probably anti-air is okay, honestly. Stand Fierce anti-air is okay, too. It's not that great, though. Stand Fierce cancels, though. And there are combos that use that. That's not really one of them. But there are links you can go for where you combo into, like, Stand Fierce. But it's as low as normal, so usually you can't do them. But it's optimal damage. Like, it's, I think it's as high as damage cancel. One way to find out, I'm turning on attack data. It does 90. So I think Close Fierce and Crouch Fierce both do 90 as well. No, Close Fierce is 100. Wow, both of them do 100. So 90 is actually weak. Like, Far Fierce is weaker than Close. So, cool. Let me see here. Sand Short, anti-airs, but it's otherwise really terrible. And the anti-air damage is not worth the risk, especially when you consider Akuma only has, like, 850 health. So you don't want to anti-air with it. It's really bad. Stand Medium Kick is alright. It's mostly for beating other, like, Shoto low forwards and stuff. Like, if someone's trying to low forward you, and you predict they're going to low forward and stand medium kick at the same time, the standing medium kick will beat it clean. It's got a very small hurtbox. It's hard to counterpoke. But it doesn't go very far, and it's kind of got a long animation, so it's not super useful. It's an okay poke. Akuma doesn't... Shadows don't really have pokes, because they got fireballs instead. Sand Hard Kick is actually a poke, and it's amazing. There's a couple key things to know about this move. One, you probably already know, but... you can link out of it. You can link out of it. There you go. And that's... Crouch Jab is the easiest link, but oftentimes it doesn't work. Or, like, Light DP is an equally easy link. But sometimes the range will make it so those don't work. Crouch Short is 1 frame harder. And I think Low Strong is the same speed as Crouch Short. But Low Short is more reliable because it doesn't push the opponent out as much. Like, if you go for Crouch Strong into Tatsu, sometimes the Tatsu whiffs. But if you go into Low Short to Tatsu, the Tatsu will usually hit. So, Low Short is sort of the better option, even though it does less damage than Low Strong. It's the same speed, and it pushes out less, so it's usually better. So that's sort of the... This is sort of the thing you'll usually be going into after a Stand Run House. Stand Run House, Low Short. It's a really useful combo for Akuma. And then, theoretically, if you wanted to keep the combo going, it would end up looking something like that. But we'll get to that combo in a second. The big thing about Stand Round House, it forces stand on hit, so if the opponent's crouching, you don't have to worry about anything. But on block, it's actually the second hit can whiff on a lot of characters. It's range dependent. Yeah, see like that? So if you use it like a poke, it's safe if you get both hits. But if you use it like a poke and the second hit whiffs, it's actually unsafe. So try this out on me, Stand Round House. That was close enough, that was good. Yeah, you can get punished for it. And that's pretty bad. I did a really unoptimized punish, actually. It probably looks something like this. The first hit is what pushes you out of the second hit. So it's pretty easy to get the second hit by itself. And the second hit's the one that's frame advantage enough to combo out of. So it's not too bad if you get the second hit only. It's also unduckable. But if you get the first hit, the second hit can whiff. Anyway. That wasn't really any better. Something like that. I don't know, dude. I don't know what Akuma does, but something like that. I was going to think, like, Maybe low forward fireball, FADC, low forward light Tatsu uppercut, something like that. That's, I don't know. Maybe just crouch fierce, light Tatsu uppercut would be optimal for Akuma. Anyway, the point is you can punish it on reaction, and good players will do that. So you can't just spam it, but at the same time, it's frame advantage when it works and safe on block and gets you in. So it's pretty good to go for. And don't forget that in emergency scenarios, when you're pushing the advantage, you can't just teleport away. If the opponent has like a good reversal, like let's say you do this on, maybe not Zangief, because I think it's a punish. I think SPD can punish it. I think it's like minus two. But like let's say you do it on someone with like Adon with two bars, and you don't want to be next to him. You're like, okay, like it didn't work. I didn't hit him. I don't want to be here. You can teleport away. Usually pretty safe. Let's see here. Adon usually runs Ultra One versus Akuma though, so watch out for that. Close hard kick, I don't know if it does anything. It might just be useless. Down back for me real fast. Down back. Just hold down back. Yeah, it's not an overhead. In third strike, it was an overhead, I think. But not this game. I don't know if it does anything. It might just be useless. It might anti-air. I don't know. Close stand forward. Force to stand. It's a pretty important button for that reason. Check this out. If your combos into, like, Tatsu, Tatsu only hits standing opponents. So a lot of combos will just not work on crouching opponents. Yeah, this is an online training session. But if you use stand forward forces stand, so the same combos will actually pick up. And that's really important. And that's Akuma's only force stand move besides crouch fierce, which you can't link into. So ordinarily, if you were holding down, I'd go for crouch fierce into Tatsu, and that would work. But if I connected some jabs, I can't do jab into crouch fierce. That's not a link. So I'd have to do like into stand forward. But that's how he combos. You have to do, you know, you have to react to the fact that the opponent's crouching and then, like, do a new combo based on it, and that's what you do. Close roundhouse could be grabs. I'm actually not sure. Like, if you did it meaty, I don't know. Maybe it, like, pushes you out of the throw range, something like that. It's not really worth considering. Close strong, I don't know what it does. It's fast. I'm pretty sure it's either 3 frames or 4. I don't know if it has a purpose beyond that. Akuma has other 3-frame moves in his jabs and his uppercut, so close strong is not super essential. But I think it is 3 frames, so if it is 3 frames, it would be your go-to punish for -3 moves, of which there are almost none. What else? Have I hit all of them? Close fierce. It's fast enough to link into. Oh, we'll get to that. So you can link into close fierce, so it's used for combos a lot. And, I think close short, I don't think cancels at all, but you can link out of it. Yeah, that's like a Tokido combo. Crouch short, stand short, low strong. That's like a combo Tokido goes for sometimes. It's good because stand short doesn't push out very much, so you can do stuff like into throw. And you don't even really need that much forward movement. I think you might not need any. I need a little bit. Akuma might have a car throw, though. I don't know. I'm not sure if Akuma has a car throw off of that. I can't tell if it's just because I'm holding forward. Overhead. It's an overhead. It's 2 hits. Does decent damage. It comes out fast enough that most people don't. In my experience, this usually works. Okay? You're more liable to have someone reversal you just because they're matching reversals than you are to have someone reaction block this thing. No one ever blocks this thing. Even offline. Honestly. Like, overheads work all the time. As long as you're pushing that offense, like, you can really freak people out just by pushing this button every now and then. And every now and then I like to do 2 overheads in a row just to show people that I mean business. But a lot of people, especially beginners, tend to stand block as soon as they eat an overhead. So they'll be, like, down backing, and then I'll, like, overhead them, and then they'll start high backing. And so a really easy thing to do, it's not a great idea, necessarily, especially against good opponents, but, like, one thing I often do is something like that. It's a really, really simple little string. The overhead, people freak out, start high blocking, and then the low forward fireball just hits low. And it's safe, you know? There's no risk to it. There's not a whole lot of risk. The biggest risk you're taking here is that someone's going to uppercut you after the towards strong. But most people will just block both, or block, you know, the low forward. So it's not really super rewarding, but it's not really super risky. What other grounded... I don't think he has any other grounded command moves, does he? I'm trying to think. I can't think of any. Crouching moves. Crouch jab is really fast. It's your main combo tool. Jab, 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 jab. It's really important to be able to do jab, 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 Tatsu. It's a very important combo for Akuma players. That's actually a better combo if you can hit it. Jab, 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 strong. That's like a really basic combo. Usually you use short, jab, strong, because short hits low, and it's the same difficulty as jab, jab. So you might as well have a low starting combo instead of a non-low starting combo. So if you're an Akuma player, that's really useful to learn. Iroyu has that combo too, so I do it all the time. No, I don't play on fight stick, I play on pad. Yeah, like that. And then you go into light Tatsu. Some characters you can't pick up light Tatsu because it goes too far, so you do like hard Tatsu. But I think that's usually not an issue. I think Decapri, this combo doesn't work, but that'll probably be patched in the not too far future. But I would definitely advise, I just dropped it, I would definitely advise if you can't do this combo reliably to learn to do this combo reliably. And if it's too hard, you should just do short jab, jab, which is easier. You do have to time the second jab late so that you can cancel it, because you can't chain into the jab and then still cancel it. It's one of the little bullshit rules of this game, just to make combos harder. But the timing that it works is about 3 frames, which is decently lenient. 3 frames is big enough that you'll never drop it, like as long as you're on point. 2 frames is big enough that you'll never drop it as long as you're on point if you're a good player. But like 3 frames is big enough for like anyone. If, as long as you know the window, you'll get it most of the time. I plink on pad, but I'm not going to tell you my... I literally put my finger between the buttons, and then I like hit one button slightly before the other. But I do plink, and I do play on pad. Are we referencing that? Someone asked me one time if I plinked on pad, and someone asked me, like, I said yes, and they said, how do you do it? And I said, because I'm a god. Yeah. People remember that. Was that a car throw? That looks like a car throw. Far Fierce? Yeah, look at that. Alright, so that's a combo. You would do something like this. You do crouch short, stand short, and then in reaction to blocking, like down back for me, on reaction to blocking, you'd go for a car throw. And then on reaction to it hitting, you'd go for crouch strong and then do a link. So that's a really easy thing Akuma can do to fuck around with the opponent. It was you. It's Jun's Lord. Jun's Lord. That's funny. That's a. It's got to be like a 2-frame link, I think. I don't know. The first hit is a chain. The second hit is probably a 2-frame link. It feels pretty easy, to be honest. It's probably 2 or 3. Anyway. What else is there? Crouch short. Slower than crouch jab, I think. Ken's crouch short is 3, but I'm pretty sure Ryu's and Akuma's are 4. So it's a frame slower than crouch jab. It's also not frame advantage at all. You can combo into crouch jab because it chains, but it doesn't link into anything. It's really slow. I mean, it's not really slow. It's really frame disadvantage. It's like plus 1 on hit, and then like minus something on block. Something like that. I don't know. Left forward is pretty much the best button for shadows. It goes pretty far. It's your farthest range cancel. Akuma actually has Stand Fierce as well, but I think left forward still goes farther. And a lot of people, for example, sweep a lot, and sweep is good because it gets knockdowns and stuff like that. But basically, low forward fireball is safe and spammable, and it stops. You can do it after any combo, like on block, and it'll just be like, you know, some free block damage. Maybe they stand block because they think you're far enough away, so like you can get an extra little tag hit in there. It's really safe to go for, and you can actually combo into it, but it's kind of hard. I think it's 1 frame. I just hit it, but I blinked it, so there you go. What else is there about that? You can do Stand Roundhouse into that. It's 1 frame, and that'll work from the absolute maximum range that Stand Roundhouse can combo. So that's useful sometimes. If you get a really bad Stand Roundhouse, you can still pick up low forward into hard Tatsu. But it's kind of hard, and I'm missing it. I don't quite know the timing after Stand Roundhouse. There you go. And I think that's actually max damage anyway, so you might do that just to get, you know, your hardest hit possible. Actually, after Stand Roundhouse, you can combo a close Fierce, but it depends on how far. But you need, like, a good Stand Roundhouse, like that one. So usually you'd be going for, like, low short or low strong or something like that. But, like, Stand Fierce can work, and low forward can work. And low forward doesn't do that much pushback, so you can usually combo light Tatsu. And that's something you do often as punishes. Okay, there's other uses of low forward. Low forward's just a really good poke anyway, because it goes really far. You can stab people with it. Walk in, walk out, low forward is like a common thing that people do. Make sure you don't accidentally... If you're doing walk in, low forward, fireball, make sure you don't accidentally get walk in, low forward, uppercut, which is a thing that people do all the time. It's a really bad drop, because you can just, you know, you're just unsafe. So you want to do walk in, and then, like, you want to go to back, and then roll to down forward, roll to down and do low forward, and then do like forward punch. You just basically just wait a little bit or waste some time with a weird motion. Well, not like that though. And then you can do walk in low forward fireball without too much difficulty. Low forward from max range doesn't come with the fireball. That's a pretty big deal. So like if someone's on point, they can actually punish you for doing it. I don't know what Akuma would do. Here, do low forward fireball on me. Maybe like that. That doesn't work. Hold on, let me think. Oh shit. I got this. I was trying to do Ultra 2. Ultra 2 would theoretically work, but hell if I can do that in that tiny of a window. Oh, I got it. This animation is hella long, but I guess we're just gonna sit through it. But that would work. The point is, other characters can do other things there that will punish you. And Akuma doesn't have great things to do there, but other characters might. Like Ryu can EX-ray you, for sure. So it's not a two-block string unless you're pretty close, but if you're pretty close, I'm pretty sure it is a two-block string. Just for the record, his jabs aren't frame advantage enough to combo fireballs, I think. His fireball's pretty slow. It's not like Ryu's or Ken's. It's more like Ken's than Ryu's. So you need to have medium buttons to combo into fireball, I think. Pretty sure. Low forward, off. Like, let's say you do a jab uppercut on me. Or let's say you whiff a jab uppercut, okay? And I see that you whiff a jab uppercut. Just do one. It doesn't really matter. Yeah, like that. Like, if I was going to go for a punish, maybe not for Akuma, because I might do Stand Roundhouse, but for a lot of characters, if I was going to go for a punish and I saw that, I don't necessarily have time to do, like, a walk-in close fierce or anything like that. So often you just want to do the fastest move that you can, like, react with. And for Akuma, it would probably be, like, low forward and then just Tatsu. So it's like a ranged punish that's really useful. Like, if you're not point-blank, that's what you would do if you didn't have very much time to act. Which happens after, like a lot of moves, like Honda Super. You don't have a whole lot of time to punish that, and you're not point-blank. So you'd probably just do, like, a low forward Tatsu. I mean, you'd probably Ultra or something like that in a perfect world. Sweep is really awesome. Goes really far. It's actually farther than low forward. There are ranges where low forward will just whiff, but sweep will connect. It causes a knockdown. Akuma loves knockdowns, so those are useful. I did the wrong version. I don't really know what Akuma... There's a lot of things Akuma can do. You can do like a cross-up. You could do like a dive kick, not cross-up. You could do like a demon flip, maybe. Do a dive kick that doesn't cross-up. You can do a demon flip into like a palm. I don't know, dude. Akuma's got a lot of options. You could do, sure, wake up into a meaty fireball. You wouldn't do it from that close because like a lot of characters could reversal you. But like that's free chip damage, honestly. Like you might as well take free chip damage. A really good one that people often do is jump in hard kick, which is, you know, you could anti-air it, but like some characters can't get reliable anti-airs when they're waking up off the ground. And then you could also do jump over into air Tatsu, and that punishes people trying to look for Shoryukens. I'm not getting it. And also you can combat up that on reaction to like another sweep, so you reset the scenario. Or even into like a Shoryuken works as well. I'm not very good at this. I'm used to Ken's timing now. This timing is more like Ryu's. Or Evil Ryu's even. Crouch Fierce. Anti-airs. It's also quite high damage. You'll typically use it in punishes and stuff because it rolls real easily. Oh, let me try something. Okay. What? Oh, an instant air fireball. I got it. I see ya. That works, but I think it's usually unsafe. But that works. And you can get weird cross-ups like that too. I'm not an expert in things Akuma. Like, I know I'm doing this tutorial right now, but I honestly don't have a good grasp of his wake-up game. So, you probably normally do that like this. Maybe not like that. I don't know. But anyway, sweep is really useful. You can combo off of it from Sand Jab, I think. But it's... I don't know. You don't really see people do that combo that often. You can also combo out of it from Light Tatsu, but that's kind of tight. I think it works on Akuma. It's one frame on Akuma. It doesn't work at all on a tiny list of characters, but it works on most characters, so you can combo it like that. Otherwise, a sweep, I don't know, it's alright. It's an alright move. What else is there? Is that all grounded normals? Did you just say some words at me? I can't hear anything right now. Type whatever you want to say. Apparently. Oh, okay. Cool.
Sorry.
No, it's fine. Anyway, low strong? Are you off the phone? Low strong, it's frame advantage enough that you can link out of it. So, oftentimes for Akuma punishes, you'll see combos like that. It's a nice little combo. Low strong, low strong. You can also do low strong, low jab for added ease of use. That's a really easy combo to do, so I recommend it for anyone who's like, you know, you don't have to worry about like, you don't have to worry about chaining for that combo. It's a 3-frame link with no fear of chaining. So, yeah, you got the link, but you didn't get the cancel. There it is. Yeah. But low strong is a frame harder, but does more damage. And actually, I think you can do low strong stand fierce on a lot of characters, including Akuma. So that's like optimal damage. That actually might be better than stand fierce by itself, so that's pretty useful to go for. It's probably 2 frames, if I were to guess, based on what I know of. I'm pretty sure stand fierce is the same speed as low strong. So that's there. I don't think anything else. Crouch fierce is by itself, and I think stand fierce by itself are both unsafe, so make sure that you cancel them. You don't want to just do that. You want to do something like that. But you usually wouldn't poke with it, so it doesn't really matter that much anyway. You usually wouldn't do that move unless you knew it was going to hit. What else? Air moves, I guess. Ninja jump, fierce, air to air is pretty well. Ninja jump medium kick is really good in some matchups because it prevents approach, like versus Zangief and T-Hawk and stuff like that. Ninja jump hard kick is pretty useless. Towards jump hard kick is usually the normal people use when jumping in. It's good. Does pretty high damage. Goes far. Ninja jump jump in fierce. I don't know if it's any better or worse. Maybe it is. No idea. Jump strong. Pretty sure it's useless. Jump forward. Jump short and jump forward are both cross-ups. And jump short has next to no block stun, which means you can throw someone really early after you connect with it. I'm doing it like if you were blocking. So actually try and, yeah. You'd have to delay it a little bit or just, you know, have an opponent block it and then throw them. And that surprises people because it's really fast. But jump forward's the cross-up you usually use. And jump forward is, you can combo out of it pretty easily. One thing to note is that after a jump-in, after a cross-up, you won't be the same range away from the opponent. So, like, if I do a cross-up into low-strong into Tatsu, that actually won't work. Because you're not as close to me as you normally are. Actually, I just hit it, but I didn't get the combo. Hold on. I don't know what Akuma combos might drop. That one seems to still work. What about... Alright, that doesn't work at all. Low-strong, low-jab, low-strong. But I think after a non-cross-up, that does work. Yeah. That's still in range. So, yeah, the point is, like, some combos, like this one. You could just do jump in and do that combo. I was a little sloppy, so I wasn't in for the Tatsu. There, I was in for the Tatsu. But after a cross-up, that'll never work. And I think after jump short, it might work, because short pushes out less. Yeah. So, I didn't combo from the short there, actually, but, you know. Proof of concept, short pushes out less distance. So you can't go for normal confirm combos after a cross-up. You have to go for slightly shorter ones. But that's okay, because you can use the cross-up to help you confirm. Like, I can, like, reaction C. I can just do, like, low jab, low strong. And I can reaction C that you're not blocking and go for a Tatsu. For what it's worth, though, well, we'll talk about his combos in a minute here. Special moves, I guess. The defining special move of Akuma, the one that is most unique to him, is Air Fireball. It's really good. They've continually nerfed it every single version of this game, and it's still quite useful even after all the nerfs. I think right now it only does 40 damage, which is almost nothing. It controls space really well. If you're just jumping up and jumping back and throwing air fireballs against like someone like Zangief, he has a really hard time approaching you. And you can throw different arcs based on, you know, what you're trying to do. Maybe that's the safest one to throw, the light one. Hard one goes the furthest. What about his kick? What kick? All of these names. Dive kick. Oh yeah, dive kick. Oh yeah, I should mention that. Down medium kick midair. Not that one, the other one. Yeah. It's not that good. It's not as good as Evil Ruse, but it's still good enough that you should use it sometimes. It doesn't cross up on arcs that would cross up. Like, if I were here and I jumped over you, I would get a cross up. But if I were the same distance away and I did a dive kick, I wouldn't cross up. And especially meaty, you can combo out of dive kick. It's easier meaty than it is non-meaty, but you can combo like a jab or something like that. I just did it. And then from that jab, you can combo, you know, the sky's your oyster. The sky's your oyster. The world's your oyster, the sky's the limit. Okay. Whatever. Something like that. Crouch jab, stand fierce. So air fireball. One thing about it is that it stops Akuma midair when he does it, which is quite useful sometimes. Like, throw me a fireball, like a grounded one. If I saw a fireball incoming on the ground, I could jump and throw my own air fireball, like, on reaction to your fireball. And that would not only, like... I'm fucking up. That would not only allow me to dodge your fireball, but it would also put me advantage in the fireball war. And it's just, like, it's free, you know? Like, I build meter from throwing that air fireball. All of a sudden, you can't throw another fireball immediately because you've got to, like, try and avoid mine. I can maybe push you in after that fireball. Stuff like that. It's really good just because it freezes you in the air. Like, I would have landed on that fireball unless I'd thrown an air fireball. And neutral jump fireballs are sort of the obvious way to use them. You don't really want to do these that much on jump in. It can be good. Because a lot of anti-airs fail against fireballs because they're designed to hit, like, really late-hitting moves. They're not designed to go through fireballs at all. Like, jump in and do a fireball on me. Let's say I'm Akuma and I want to anti-air you. If I did an uppercut right there, which I did just do, like a medium uppercut, I just get stuffed by the fireball. That was the light one on the jump in is usually the best one. But you see that? The best I can hope for is a trade, but it's still a good trade for me. But the point is, like, a lot of traditional anti-airs get stuffed by fireballs. Akuma's EX uppercut won't. Akuma's EX uppercut ignores fireballs basically the whole time it's going up. Akuma's EX uppercut is useful. Let's see here. Air EX fireball controls space for a really long time. It's possible to make the two hits of fireball combo, especially if you do it on your way down, and especially if the opponent's cornered. And that gives you a lot of time to confirm a combo. And also you can do jump back EX fireball, and that's... it puts enough pressure on the opponent. Like, check this out. Just by doing jump back EX fireball, it puts enough pressure that I can demon flip in. Like, that's how long it lasts. That I can actually, like, if you're blocking it, I can actually, like, get a demon flip going and then get back in and do some guaranteed chip damage or something like that. It lasts for quite a long time, basically. And you can just see those EX fireballs connecting and just react and pick up combos sometimes. Like that. So that's really good. Once again, easier in the corner. But you can do that for regular fireballs, too. You can pick up an EX a fireball into a combo. And you can juggle out of them, too, on air-to-air connects. They air-to-air really well. And then if you ever get an air-to-air connect, you can often pick up combos. Akuma, I think it's a juggle state, so you have to go into stuff that juggles, which usually for Akuma is his uppercut. Just combo with the hard uppercut. But you can combo with the Tatsu on a lot of them, too. Like, hold up for a second for me. That was a really low connect, unfortunately. Yeah, you can go into Tatsu for some of them. It's not super useful, though. Uppercut's usually better. Grounded Fireball works exactly like Ryu's and Ken's Grounded Fireball. Comes out really fast, recovers really fast. It's a very spammable fireball. It's one of the most spammable fireballs in the game. Akuma honestly doesn't use it that much just purely because his air fireball is really good too, but he still does it all the time. It's your only safe special move, I think. Or at least the only safe one that you can true block string into. Max damage, corner, hard kick, Tatsu after light Tatsu. I think that works mid-screen. I don't think it's max damage, all of these names. Anyway, Grounded Fireball, three different speeds. Probably know how that works. The EX one knocks down at all ranges, even if it's only one hit. Like, throw a fireball at me. If I EX fireball and it goes through your fireball, I lose a hit, but I still get the knockdown hit. So that's good. If you land it close... Yeah, we'll get to that in a second. If you land it close, it does... it creates a juggle state, so you can combo out of it. And that also works in corners really easily. You usually won't get that unless you use an FADC. That's sort of a rare scenario. With an FADC, it's really common, but you usually wouldn't use an FADC, something like that. So you won't really see that often. But you will see it in corners all the time. Is oftentimes in corners, you'll go for like a combo like that, and then you'll pick up an uppercut. That's a really common thing to go for. So EX Fireball is really good because it causes a knockdown. Like, Ryu's causes a knockdown too, and it's really good. Ken's doesn't. Ken's is still good, but it's not as good as Nakuma's and Ryu's, in my opinion. Fireball... I don't know, dude. It's space control. You throw a lot of fireballs, you find out what the opponent can do to get around your fireballs, usually jumping, and then you look for those jumps, you wait for them, you try and bait them by, like, you know, throwing enough fireballs that people want to jump in. And then when you smell a jump coming, you wait for them to jump in, you just uppercut them. And I guess we'll talk about uppercut right now. We'll talk to Red Fireball right now. Red Fireball's got very bad startup, you may have noticed. Takes a really long time to come out. You can literally see that animation and hear Akuma say Shakunets, and then just on reaction jump in and get a full combo on him. So, you don't want to do it from a range where the opponent can jump in, or from a timing that people can jump in. So, for example, a really common time to do it is on Wake Up. You get a meaty fireball on them. There's no downside there. There's no risk whatsoever. Depends on the character you're fighting. Like, Adon probably could have done Wake Up Ultra 1. But Akuma couldn't have done anything. So, that's a common one that you see. It's free chip damage, you know? What else does it do? A lot of people do it from outside jumping range, and they do it just to win fireball wars. Like, if I throw a red fireball at the same time you throw a normal fireball, I can actually pick up a punish on you. And even if I don't, like, if you throw an EX fireball and I throw a red fireball, mine just beats yours. So it's really good at controlling the space in fireball wars. And there's other little tricks to it. Like, I've been doing the hard one, but the light one does, like, 200 stun if it connects, which is quite a lot. And, what else? The medium one... You can... Check this out. If you throw a fireball, and I throw, like, a red fireball, you're usually going to be expecting... Like, throw a fireball for me really fast. You're usually going to be expecting... Keep throwing them, actually. For me to, like... For mine to go through yours. And, like, you know. So you'll, like... You'll throw a fireball, but then you'll see that mine's... That I threw a red one, then you'll just jump, you know? You're doing... I'll throw mine on reaction to yours. Yeah, like that. You'll, like, jump over it or something. But, like, if I throw a light one, it'll actually crash. And since there's no fireball... You know the fireball law, right? You can only have one fireball on the screen at a time. And then if there's already one, you try and throw another one, nothing happens. If I throw a light fireball on purpose against your fireball, and then they crash, like... Do it, yeah. You might jump expecting, like, the red fireball to come out and hit you. Well, that was weird. And then I can throw another fireball immediately, and you might land on that fireball. So it can really surprise people. It's got a lot of shock value to it. I did a hard one for some reason. I don't know. That's really high level fireball play, so, like, we won't bother that much with it. It juggles too. The EX one recovers really fast. It comes out quite fast, and it's got next to no recovery. So it's a really good move, and you can use it for pressure and stuff. I don't know if you can combo into it. Yes, you can combo into it. From Close Fierce and possibly Far Fierce and possibly Crouch Fierce. Yeah, you can pick up the EX Fireball. I don't know if there are good follow-ups, though. That's the only thing. Yeah, there might not be any follow-ups. Let me try this. Alright, you can tag one hit of Fierce Uppercut on a cornered opponent or after an FADC. So really pretend there's no follow-ups. but it is quite high pressure and quite high damage, so that's something. Akuma's got much higher damage, of course. Red Fireball is not a super useful move. You mostly just do it on people who are fireballing a lot to win the Fireball War, which is the same reason you use Air Fireball, so you'll probably mostly be using that. Shuriken. It's really fast. It's 3 frames. Comes out really, really quickly. Does pretty high damage. You'll be ending most of your combos with this. It'll pick up some punishes that are really hard to pick up. Like a Reversal Shoriken will always punish like a Rekka. If it's an unsafe Rekka, you know. Like if Feilong's like this far away, does a light Rekka, you can do just hard Shoryuken. Super easy reversal will always pick up the punish. I don't know about Akuma's, actually. Akuma's Shorykens don't go very far. Like that, I didn't even get all the hits from that range. Akuma has the most vertical Shoryuken. It's really easy to get the jab one to connect. The jab one's like the same as the other two Shotos. But the hard one is almost straight vertical. The main purpose of this move, the definitive function of this move, is just anti-air. In a perfect world, I think the medium one's the most safe, the most invincible for Akuma. So you would be crouching, and you would do a crouching shoryuken. You know how to do a crouching shoryuken, right? Yeah, I look like a crouching shoryuken. Yeah, definitely a crouching shoryuken. So you'd be watching for anti-airs. Maybe you throw a lot of fireballs, and then you think the opponent's going to jump over a fireball. You watch for an anti-air, and then you just medium uppercut. And that works quite reliably. hit me with an anti-air. Perfect. And hard uppercut works too and does slightly more damage, but it's less invincible, so you need to be more precise with it. But theoretically, hard is the better one in a perfect world. And of course, EX does a ton of damage and has a lot of invincibility, so that one will just anti-air for days, regardless of how you time it. Make sure you only use two buttons when doing an EX uppercut, because if you use three buttons, you'll get a teleport, because that's an input for one of his four teleports. It's kind of hard getting all three hits of EX1 on a jumping opponent. But it's more about the reliability of anti-air than it is about the damage. Yeah, that was it. Let's see here. Akuma doesn't really have juggles after anti-air uppercut. His light uppercut recovers really slowly, and his hard and medium ones recover even more slowly still. So, Akuma, jump for me. Neutral jump. Oftentimes with Ryu and Ken, they could... Repeatedly. They could do, just hold up, yeah. They could do a light uppercut into an EX fireball, but for Akuma, that's restrictively difficult because he doesn't have... He has really slow recovery on his uppercut, so that'll almost never happen. So, usually it's just a combo ender. For Akuma, it's usually an anti-air combo ender. And it's also invincible, So if someone's putting the pressure on real hard, maybe you'll just do a jab uppercut to try and tell them, fuck off. And that's really important for Akuma. It's a really good defensive option. It comes out really fast. It's invincible for a long time. So people tend to be afraid to go in. Not even necessarily afraid. If you're an Akuma and you show them just one time that you're willing to uppercut, people really want to get an uppercut punish on Akuma. So they'll deliberately drop their pressure waiting for you to uppercut. And that's good for you because it'll give you time to get away. It'll give you, someone will do, they'll be doing, a block string or something like that, and then they'll be like, oh, I want to see the uppercuts, and then you could just, hold backwards, or teleport away, yeah, something like that. So that's good. So uppercut is an important defensive tool because it's good at getting people off, and it's good at motivating people to not pressure as well. Even beyond the ability to just beat, their pokes and stuff. If you're going to beat pokes with Akuma's jab uppercut, use jab. Do not use other versions. Let's say low forward me as soon as I get into range for a low forward. Okay, I'm going to walk in. If I'm doing something like that, low forward, dude. Crouch medium kick. Yeah. If I were walking in and I knew you were going to low forward, if I light uppercutted, that just gets the connect. Works pretty reliably. If I'm trying to uppercut a poke. I mean, that's a pretty hard poke to uppercut. There, I got it. But, if I did hard, it would be useless. Because, one, it's a much bigger commit. But even if I get the poke, I don't knock down. You see that? I think medium knocks... No, medium doesn't knock down either. So you have to use light if you're doing, against a ranged opponent. Never use medium or hard. I think EX doesn't knock down on the first hit either. We'll find out right now really easy. No, EX knocks down on the first hit. So you could use EX too, I guess. But, honestly, light's a much smaller commit, which is good. Someone could commit to something at the same time that you do light uppercut, and then they might miss a punish. And if you do hard uppercut, even if they committed to something, they could still pick up a punish on you. That's a pretty big deal. That's uppercut in a nutshell. What about Tatsu, I guess? Akuma's got a lot of special moves, dude. I'm starting to realize. Light Tatsu, you already know. Super important. Super fundamental for Akuma and Evil Ryu. Picks up a hit. It's only the single attack. Every other Tatsu has an initial hit that, hits on the way up, but Light Tatsu doesn't. It only has the one hit that launches, but then you've got the pickup for the combo, so, who can complain? Most other Shadows would do something like Stand Fierce into Fierce Uppercut for punishes, but Akuma adds a Light Tatsu in there, and I think it adds a tiny bit of damage, and also gives you a lot more time to react to combos. Stuff like that. But that's, fundamental to pretty much every single combo he does. Light Tatsu. There are ranges where Light Tatsu simply won't work because it's too far. After, I think, low jab, low strong, low forward. I think that works. Now I'm beginning to doubt myself. Yeah, there it was. Well, some of it was. After that combo, Light Tatsu is too far, and it just won't reach. Okay, never mind, it worked. Well, I didn't get the combo at all. There are some combos, you'll just have to take my word for it, where Light Tatsu will not reach. And for those combos, you often have to do Hard Tatsu, and that doesn't create a launching state, but it does pick up from ranges where Light Tatsu won't. Like, that doesn't reach, but that does reach. Also, for what it's worth, you can go over fireballs with a Hard Tatsu, predictably. It's really risky to do, so I don't recommend it, especially with a character with as low health as Akuma. But you can't throw it on reaction to the fireball, but you have to predict. You have to know that the fireball is coming. I don't know if Akuma's is that good for this. Yeah, there it was. And actually, if you get a nice prediction going, and you Hard Tatsu from max range, and actually punish a fireball, you can pick up a Shoryuken, which is kind of cool. Looks neat anyway, but I really don't recommend it. It's very risky to just go for Tatsus and footsies, because like I could just do this. You predict a Tatsu and you go in, and I just, you know, that's a lot of damage for Akuma to take. I did hard and I missed a hit, so it wasn't that bad. But let's say I do medium. Ouch. You don't want to just take those. And like worse things could happen. I could do this even. I dropped that. Do it again. I think Akuma's Tatsu is unsafe too. That's not the punish I wanted. I'm not used to this block. There you go. I could do something like that. That would hurt. You wouldn't want that at all. That's Tatsu in a nutshell, I guess. Just combo into it. It's a good combo tool. Like Tatsu launches, you can combo into uppercut or sweep. Pretty much the only follow-ups of note. You can go for Light Tatsu into Low Strong, and then reset into... cancel the Low Strong into Demon Flip, and that can catch people who aren't expecting that. And you can maybe get some sneaky resets. There's one in particular that I'm going for. Hold on while I try and get it. This is a harder juggle than I realized. There you go. Something like that. It's like a Goku reset. You can do that. You're guessing on whether it'll work or not, but like if someone's not expecting it, it definitely can work. And that particular setup is cool because I think it catches them in the 4 stand frame, but I could be wrong. It might be unduckable, it might not, I have no idea. Try holding, yeah, just down back after the Light Tatsu connects. Might take a couple tries, won't it? I can't even get the link now. Whoa, that was cool. Hit you on the back. Oh, I got you. Yeah, there you go. Cool. So you got a reset, but it can just be uppercutted, so be aware. But like some characters don't have an uppercut or anything like that. And you can also, of course, reset into like dive kicks and stuff. That's alright. It's safe. That's Tatsu in a nutshell. Air Tatsu, I guess. It's not super important. Akuma's Air Tatsu is really unique because it creates a free juggle state. Like, just hold up for me. I'm pretty sure it's a free juggle, yeah. So I can combo into anything. And Akuma doesn't... Akuma's ultras were designed with that in mind. So he can't get huge damage off of a free juggle state like a lot of characters can. But he can pick up a full damage Shoryuken. And the really useful time to go for this is the one I already sort of described. Where this is a range where I won't cross you up. But if I go for a Tatsu, it'll change my jump arc and I will cross you up. And that's very tricky to deal with. And then you can pick up, because it's a free juggle state, you can pick up a hard Shoryuken. You can get all three hits. You gotta do it pretty early. And there's a specific range that you need to be looking for. I don't know the difference between all the Tatsus for mid-air Tatsu, but I usually just do the hard one. I don't know if there's a better one to go for. You're going for it a little too far out. You gotta find a range. It's about, hold on, you'll know this range by heart before too long, but it's about here. That's about right. Oh, that was it. That was perfect. That was like the most beautiful one I've ever seen. That was too late. That was too early. These minute differences in the timing, they might seem minute, but they're not that minute. That was weird. You crossed me up with the forward going one. You've got to do it sooner than that. You've got to change your jump arc. The thing about this that's really appealing, like, check this out. Hold on, I'll try and get it on you. Do you like a wake-up Shoryuken on me? Are you ready? I did it too late myself. Prepare yourself. You see that? Well, I didn't even get the hit on you. But if you do this and the opponent does like a wake-up Shoryuken on what would otherwise work, it'll often whiff on the cross-up Tatsu, because it changes the jump arc. I was a little slow on my jump there. I think I'm screwing up your directional input. Yeah, whatever. Good enough. You can often make shurikens whiff when they would otherwise hit, which is really useful. Because people will go... Like, so this is really safe to go for, actually. There's not a whole lot people can do to punish it. And it is safe on block, too. So it's a good option midair. But it's especially good because people often don't consider that this jump is going to turn into a cross-up. And it does. I'm not the master of Akuma's timing. So this is a really good thing to go for against people who don't know the game. But it's a really good thing to go for even against pros. It's still useful even at the highest level. But at the highest level, you can do regular jump-ins too, and they'll be expecting the cross of Tatsu, and the regular jump-in will just whack them for tons of damage. Let's throw some FADCs into the... No, forgot a special move. He's got Demon Flip. Demon Flip, you can cancel into it for pressure. It's alright as a cancel. It doesn't combo from anything. I think you can do Demon Flip into... I think you can do, like, Stand Fierce, cancel to Demon Flip, cancel to... I think that works on tall characters. For the most part, you can't combo into Demon Flip. Demon Flip's just something you do. But the point about Demon Flip is that it can create... Like, do a wake-up uppercut again. You can have jump-ins that are basically impossible to anti-air with Demon Flip Dive Kick. It's a really tricky move. And on reaction to a Demon Flip Dive Kick, you can actually, like... Demon Flip Dive Kick doesn't knock down, so you can, like, combo out of it if the opponent... I dropped that. If the opponent doesn't block it. So it's basically free chip damage, but if it actually hits, like, you've got a little bit of time. Like, that's just your normal... Like, that's totally safe to go for after a Demon Flip Dive Kick. Yeah, yeah. And it can cross up, I think. I actually don't know if it can cross up. I'm pretty sure it can cross up. It might always hit on the front, but I'm pretty sure it can hit from behind. But it can create these really tricky arcs, and they're really useful after a knockdown especially. Like, I did a forward throw, two forward dashes into medium Demon Flip. That's really tricky to anti-air. And... Okay, you got it, actually. Akuma's uppercut's good for this sort of thing, so there you go. But, like, there are other ones. I'm not sure of other ones, but, like, I know there are other ones where even, like, the best uppercuts will, will whiff. So it's good for that. What else about it? Stand Hard Punch to Ultra 2. No, I'll do that. Give me a minute here, dude. I've got plenty of things I have to go over. From Demon Flip, you can do EX Fireball. Yeah, EX Fireball. That stops you midair, so that's really good. A lot of people will see Demon Flips, and they'll try and air-to-air you, because it doesn't air-to-air very well. Or they'll try and anti-air you. And let's say you do a Demon Flip in on me right now, and I want to uppercut it. Yeah, see that? You just stuff my uppercut with an EX Fireball. That costs a bar, but at the same time, you have to consider that it'll catch people who are trying to punish you. So it's pretty good. People might not anti-air you because they're afraid that you're going to do the EX Fireball. So it's good to keep that in mind that you can do that. The punch, it knocks down on hit, so you can't combo out of it. It breaks armor. It's the only Demon Flip follow-up that breaks armor, but I suppose the throw ignores focusing opponents, so it doesn't really matter. It used to be an overhead. It's not anymore. It has the fastest recovery of anything you can do out of Demon Flip. Like, this thing stops you midair. Throw stops you midair. Palm has no ground recovery. It just works like a regular jump in. You have the normal 4 frames landing recovery. So you can do a lot of option selects with Palm, but I don't know what they are, so I can't efficiently show you what they are. But, like, Tokido does them all the time. So if you watch any amount of Tokido footage, you'll see, like... You'll see the setups, and you can just emulate them, you know. And then he's got the throw follow-up, which it only hits standing opponents. No Demon Flip follow-up is an overhead. You can actually react to a Demon Flip by holding down back, and that's not even a terrible idea. Try it out. Like, if I do Dive Kick, it's not an overhead. If I do Palm, it's not an overhead. If I do Grab, it just whiffs on crouching opponents. So a lot of people stand block whenever they see the opponent go into the air because attacks in the air are usually overheads. But if it's a Demon Flip, you can listen to the noise that Akuma makes when he jumps. When it's a Demon Flip, you're supposed to down back and maybe do like a crouching anti-air, like a crouching fierce or something like that, and that'll stuff it. But the problem with that is, like, if I do it meaty, you can't do a crouching fierce because it won't come out fast enough. like that. See that? So you can't, you know, you in wake up scenarios is actually pretty hard to deal with, but in footsies you can usually just hold down back or like air to air it or like try and anti air it with a crouching move, stuff like that. You can anti air it with anything really. Anything that's designed to anti air it usually works. But it's a tricky little move. There's a lot of different things you can do with it. I can't think of anything immediately. EX Demon Flip hones in, so if you've got someone who's throwing a lot of fireballs full screen, like a Sagat player or something, and you just want to surprise them, remember to use two buttons instead of three. Demon Flip can still grab crouching opponents, just have to do it late. I think that's not true. Hold on, let me try it a couple times. Hold down back. Oh no, he's right. Demon Flip grab can grab crouching opponents, just have to do it late. Wow, Robbie. Picking up my fucking slack right now. Cleaning up my guide. Making sure I don't say anything completely dishonest. What is the one that can not grab crouching opponents then? I mean, Guys is like that, but what about...
It might be
Gokens. It might be Gokens, yeah. Or maybe Gokens grabs crouching opponents too, dude. My whole life is, like, flipping out right now. I have no idea. Anyway. So, yeah. I guess grab is there. But you can just crouch fierce that too, so... But down backing, not necessarily the greatest option in the world, I guess. Grab recovers pretty fast, but it's not instant. Oh yeah, and this slide. Honestly, slide hits low, but you should almost never do it. It's really unsafe. It's the only Demon Flip follow-up that's really unsafe. Like, if you do Demon Flip slide, and the opponent just reacts, like, try it out. Just Demon Flip slide me. Like, boom. Punish. That hurts. That hurts a lot. Don't have that happen to you. Don't do Demon Flip slide at all. Demon Flip slide has surprise value, but like it's mostly there because it was there in Third Strike. It's not there because it's like a good option. Or like in Street Fighter Alpha, I guess. It's an Alpha. It's kind of funny. He had some follow-ups in Alpha that he doesn't have anymore. Like he could land on his back on you. Gouken can do crouchers too, apparently. I trust this guy. He seems to know what he's talking about. So that's all special moves, I think. I was going to say a couple of EX special moves that I forgot to cover. Well, EX Demon Flip goes full screen, homes in. So if someone throws if someone's throwing fireballs from full screen, you can maybe surprise them with like a Demon Flip palm. That's a little risky, but it does have some surprise value. Most people act like Akuma can't immediately get on in you. Oh yeah, teleport. I should talk about that. So teleport is a fixed... It's not... based on the opponent. For most characters, you can do teleport immediately in front of the opponent, immediately behind the opponent, and then backwards extra far. But Akuma does a fixed distance instead of a fixed location. So he'll teleport, like, so-and-so distance. And kicks, I think punches is farther than kicks. So Akuma's the only character who can efficiently teleport out of corners. Which is a pretty big deal. Pretty useful. If you're mid-screen, a teleport away, it gives up a lot of ground, but it's basically uncatchable by most of the cast. Demon Flip, let me think. If the opponent's Demon Flipping through you, if you're cornered especially, and you try and do, like, Wake Up Demon Flip or something like that, they might just, like, read you and punish it. It's unsafe at the end, basically. It's invincible for its whole animation, so you can do some pretty cool things with it. Like, check this out, throw an EX Fireball at me and then a regular one. Well, yeah, this is fine, actually. Just throw a regular fireball at me. Ta-da. You can do silly stuff like that. That's not super useful. For what it's worth, Ultra 2, you can combo. You can cancel into Ultra 2 from teleport, and that's the only time you can cancel into Ultra 2. So you can do, like that. It's kind of a weird motion. And there's some really important things you can do with that. Yeah, you seem to already know them. I'm not very good at this. But with good timing, you can get Stand Fierce or even like medium buttons. Canceled to teleport, canceled to Ultra 2. I don't think I got it. Three hits. Oh, I did get it. I think it's three hits. It's not too hard from Fierce, but it's really hard from like low forward. That might have been it. Yeah, that was it. You did it. I feel like they made this easier. I feel like I never used to be able to get it, but now I get it most of the times I attempt it. Three hits, yeah. So there you go. That's probably the easiest way that Akuma can land Ultra. He can land it any time he can land a close Fierce. Down, forward, up, forward, down, forward, up, forward, up, forward. You have to have at least one neutral between the two hits of the KKZ, which is probably what you just did, but, like, you know, just for the record, you can't just do, like, an up-forward to an up or anything like that. You have to go neutral at least once. But up-forward works, and up-forward, up. I think they can be any up for both inputs. I'm pretty sure. One of them might need to be straight up, but I doubt it based on what you just told me with your motion. But you might rock around a little bit when you get up. So like maybe you hit up on accident while going up forward. I don't know. Fuck. I couldn't tell you the input leniency of that move. Let's see here. Teleport. There's not much more to it. It's just it's invincible for a little while. It's vulnerable at the end. Use it to try and get away from the opponent. Akuma's good at running away. Akuma's best played defensively. So I think that's all our special moves. Let me take a quick look to make sure I didn't miss any important EX special moves. Just for the record, EX Shokunetsu recovers really fast and also comes out faster. EX Go Hadouken knocks down, does an extra hit. EX Air Hadouken throws another one. EX Go Shoryuken's invincible for a really long time. EX Tatsumaki. I didn't do that one at all. EX Air Tatsumaki either, but that one's kind of useless. Yeah, cool. So we'll do EX Tatsus. It launches. It does lots of hits. Does lots of damage. That's pretty much the three things that it does. One thing that's really notable is that Tatsu combos will whiff on a crouching opponent. Like, hold down for me. Hard Tatsu... gets the first hit, but it usually doesn't get the first hit in combos. But EX Tatsu will always combo. It doesn't need crouching. Like, it can work on crouching opponents, which is pretty important. So if you see a crouching opponent, you either need to do a combo into stand forward, or you need to go into EX Fireball, or you need to go into EX Tatsu. Those are, like, your only options on a crouching opponent. Anyway, yeah, you already know. EX Tatsu on a cornered opponent is a juggle state, and you can pick up a hard Shoryuken. And even an EX Shoryuken. I don't think there's anything that meaningful that Akuma can go for. But hard Shoryuken's usually your best friend here. You show that you can DP after a triple fireball in the corner? Oh yeah, yeah, I already showed that. It's not that useful though. I showed that with the EX one, I didn't show it with the normal one. Wait, triple fireball? I assume that's what you're talking about. Triple fireball. That's a weird thing to say. Let's see here. Air EX Tatsu, to the best of my knowledge, does nothing in terms of actually hitting the opponent. It's still useful because you can do stuff like this. Like, let's say, I jump in and you do an anti-air ultra. And, like, I'm trying to think. What's an ultra anti-air that you see? I don't know. I can only think of really long active ones. Let's say I jump in, you do Ryu Ultra 1 anti-air. Like, that move actually works pretty well in TR. And I'm going to land on it. I'm like, oh, shit. So I do Air EX Tatsu. And then the Ultra goes harmlessly under me, and then I can just land. Air EX Tatsu stops you midair, which is occasionally really useful. And you'll know, like, basically, sometimes something will happen beneath you. Maybe Evil Ryu Ultra 2. Something will happen beneath you, and you'll be like, shit, do I have any escapes? I'm going to get hit. And then you'll just try EX Tatsu, and it'll probably work. Maybe like anti-air 8 on Ultra 2 or something like that. And you'll be just like, oh shit, EX Tatsu. And then it works. Sometimes it won't work. Usually it does, in my experience. Usually EX Tatsu gets you out of shit. Usually you'll be able to tell whether EX Tatsu will work or not. DP FADC triple fireball. I was going to get to that. I was going to go for some meter. Talk about special moves with meter. Fireball FADC. Frame advantage enough to combo out of. You can do combos into fireball and then FADC them and combo out of them. A really common one is Stand Fierce Fireball, Stand Fierce Tatsu, which I just dropped twice. But that works, and it's really useful. Adds a lot of damage to your normal basic combos. Like, hold on, let me actually get some hard numbers. This combo does 361, and this combo does 435. So that's like 70 extra damage that you get, 74 extra damage that you get, just from burning two bars. And that's not great damage for two bars, but you have to consider that could be the difference between killing and not killing. Or it could be a better wake-up scenario. And you can actually do, like, multiple if you're so inclined. And that can add, you know, a decent amount of damage. That did, like, somewhere in the high 400s, I bet. Let's see here. Shoryuken FADC. Akuma doesn't Shoryuken FADC for damage. That's really important. Akuma only Shoryuken FADCs for safety. And now Shoryuken FADC only works on the first hit of Shoryuken on block. So you have to make a decision really quickly. Basically, let's say I want to do a jab Shoryuken on wake up or something, or during pressure, and I want to make it safe. I would do, like, jab Shoryuken FADC. I'd probably backdash for Akuma. But let's say, for theory, I forward dash. Because a lot of people don't punish that yet. Nice punish. But let's say I just do it, you know. On block, that's not very unsafe. And if it happens to hit, for example, Akuma can pick up the combo with red fireball, with a hard red fireball. You have to be pretty fast about it. Stop blocking. Like that. It feels pretty weird, but it comes out pretty naturally if you've done it a few times. You gotta be light. Light's the only one that launches on the first hit. And then half circle back hard punch. Not bad. Not bad at all. So that's like the follow-up if you get like a Shoryuken in footsies. And theoretically you can add on damage, but it's really, it does not a lot of damage at all. Like, check this out. Yeah, you can, on hit, you can FADC any hit, but you wouldn't do that. You wouldn't even do a hard uppercut if you knew it was going to hit, and then FADC it. It wouldn't be worth the bar. It still works, it's just not something you should ever do. The reason that FADC Shoryukens is for defensive options for Akuma. That damage that you're adding on, you're burning two bars to add... Hold on. Well, let's say... I'll do it outside of combo, why not? That adds 60 damage for two bars. And inside combos, it'll do even less. It's 361 to 381. Yeah, that added 20 damage. It's like, wow, cool. Let's see here. I guess that's all in terms of special moves I can think of. I guess super. Akuma super is not that useful. You'll usually be using bar. Akuma super is kind of hard to use well. The really obvious time where you can use it is after a focus stack. Works pretty well. But also, if you're really good with your inputs, if you're really clean with your inputs, you can use it like basically an SPD. Because it's got one frame startup, so you can't jump out of it on reaction to the super freeze. So you could do setups that leave you point blank against the opponent. And then, like, if they hold up, they can't get out. I just tried one and I fucked it up. I'm not very good at this one. I haven't done it in a while. Whoa. Whoa, where's my strong, dude? I have not done this one forever. I don't know if I'll be able to get it out. But, you know, you can do stand strong or towards strong. Yeah, light uppercut FADC into it is more damage, Robbie, but that's, again, something that you wouldn't do unless you'd gonna hit. You wouldn't FADC it. And if you didn't know it was gonna hit, you'd probably backdash. Like, this is technically optimal damage. I dropped it. Technically optimal damage, but the meter use is not worth the damage you add instead of just doing hard uppercut. Anyway, what was I talking about? Super. You can do, like... you can do... There are strings you can do that leave you point blank against the opponent. And you can get sneaky supers in like that. Like, if you tried to hold up out of that one, I'm sure you would fail. It was already too late. Like, try it out. On reaction to the super freeze. Not preemptively. Yeah, you see that? That really surprises a lot of people. Setups like that tend to work, in my experience. That's a really easy one, too. There are other ones. You can't combo into it. It's a big deal. It's a throw. What I was doing was I'm holding down forward, and I do jab, and I do it really fast, so I get just one jab. And then I do walk in, and the walk in counts as the forward motion for the demon, and then I do light kick and hard punch at the same time. So that's the jab, forward, light kick, hard punch. You gotta do it kinda... Yeah, something like, it looks like that. You're a little slow. And that time you're a little fast. It's got a very particular timing or else it doesn't work. I was still on... It's easier if the opponent's blocking. Well, that might be it. Yeah, there you go. Done. And you can do that in a lot of different scenarios and people act like you... People act like Akuma doesn't have a 1-3 throw, basically, but he does. Like, check this out. Like that. Very tricky. Very difficult to deal with. There are other times where it works really well. One time that it works really well is down back for me. Remember how, like, people tend to... That hit can whiff on crouching opponents, and people tend to go for, like, crouch fierce punishes and stuff like that. Whether they go for a punish or even if they don't, you can cancel the second... Oops. You can cancel the second hit while it's whiffing into super. And that will really... Like, that'll tend to get people who, like, are down backing. But you can't... You can't react to whether they're gonna, like, not stand block the second hit, so it's a bit risky. Let me try it again. Hold down back. Yeah, like that. Tricky. Akuma's got some neat gimmicks. These are not very practical ways of landing this. Super is 0 frames. It's got 1 frame startup, it's just 0 frames after the super freeze. It won't punish neutral moves. It'll only punish moves that are -1 or worse. It has 1 frame startup. Every move in this game has at least 1 frame startup. All demons... That's not true. If it was 0 frame startup, it would punish moves that were neutral at reversal timing. But it doesn't. It's got 1 frame that is the super freeze, and then by the time the super freeze has already happened, there's 0 frames to commit. So it's a 1 frame throw. It's 1 plus 0, it's not 0 plus 1. Yeah. Everyone dropping information. I made a video. Yeah, his ultra, is it 5? Is it 4 or 5? I don't know who to trust. His ultra is not as fast. It's not a true... You can cancel into it the same way you can cancel into other stuff. But, into his super, I mean. But you can't, it won't... You can jump out of it even at point blank. It's not instant startup. But it has invincibility. Super Demon only has, like, a couple frames of invincibility. It's, like, 1 or maybe a couple more. I don't know. I know Oni has a little bit of invincibility on his Super Demon. But I think Akuma might only have 1 frame of invincibility on his. But, like, Ultra has a decent amount. It's got, like, it's got, like, I don't know. It's got a decent amount. Like, let's say 7. Probably, like, 7 frames of invincibility. So you can use it to catch... You can use it to catch stuff that you wouldn't normally... Like, to catch punishes and stuff. I can't really think of anything. Usually you'll just be landing it after, like, focus, to be honest. It's really hard to land outside of... And it works as a punish and stuff, too. Like, let's say you uppercut me. Let's say you, like, you know... Do a Shoryuken. Maybe I'm like, you know, that's a really easy time to land Ultra. And you can actually anti-air with it too, but it's quite precise. You can't just do the Ultra to anti-air. You can, but it's really impractical because they could just hit you while you're doing the Ultra motion. So what you have to do is like down back and then do like low forward to low profile their jump in and then do the Ultra during the low forward. Dude, like jump hard kick on me. I did the right thing, but I fucked it up. Hold on. Like that. I did a low jab. I was supposed to do low forward. But the point is, you do a low forward, you cancel it to Ultra Demon, and that'll anti-air. That's like the way that people usually land anti-air. I mean, land Ultra Demon, as they land it via anti-air. But it's really hard to land Ultra Demon. It's really hard to land both of Akuma's Ultras. So don't get used to the idea that you're going to be landing Ultras as this character. What else? There must be more to this character. I guess we'll just talk about combos, because I can't think of anything else. I didn't talk about his Ultra 2 that much. I talk about how you can cancel it from teleport, which is the main way to land it. The damage is actually much higher if you cancel it from... If you don't cancel it from teleport. But trying to land it when you don't cancel it from teleport is next to impossible because it's got a really terrible hitbox and it's really slow. So try, shurikening me, I guess. Hard shuriken. Like, I guess I could go for, like, Ultra Punish for that. And that... That actually does a pretty good amount of damage. This is Ultra Double, so it'll be scaled quite a lot. But that does 100 damage more, unscaled, like if I have Ultra 2, than Teleport does. Teleport sacrifices 100 damage. Like, remember that damage that you just saw? Now compare it to this one. I hope it's, I hope I can see a visible difference. It looks almost the same. It's a more obvious difference with Ultra 2 by itself. But raw Ultras do more damage than Teleport Cancelled Ultras. And Teleport Cancelled Ultras also have a better hitbox. They tend to hit more reliably. Raw Ultras are designed to be really hard to land. Usually only in footsies. This move has a ton of invincibility, just so you know. It's invincible for a long time. You can't do it on the ground. You can, but it's insanely difficult. It requires... It takes 3 frames minimum to input this Ultra, and it takes 4 frames for Akuma to jump. So you have to do the whole Ultra motion, like, frame perfect. Frame perfect or only dropping a single frame. You have to do, like, up for 1 frame, neutral for 1 frame, up for 1 frame, and then, like, kicks. And that's really hard to do. Although it has been done by a couple people. And then... 500 damage without teleport, 421 with teleport. So it's not a hard 100 damage subtraction. What else? Why would it change in and out of teleport? It's something they did for... He didn't used to be able to cancel it from tele... No, it's a change. It was in like AE 20. It was in like AE. It was like an arcade edition when they made it like that. It had the same hitbox in both, and it was impossible to land in both. And then they made the teleport canceled one have a really good hitbox so you could actually land it. Because it used to just whiff on everything. Like, you do like teleport cancel into Ultra, and then it would like fail to punish a fireball or something like that. So they made it so the regular one still does the insane amount of damage it does, but the teleport canceled one, which is much easier to land, loses a lot of damage. That's why they did it. But I don't know when you started playing Robbie, but that's something they did. But yeah, you can punish fireballs with it. It's actually, you have to guess. Like, let's say I think you're going to throw a fireball and I teleport towards you, or even like teleport away from you if I'm up close. Like, you can do stuff like let's say on your wake up, I like teleport, you're going to shoryuken, and I teleport away from you looking for a shoryuken. Like, this is pretty safe for me to go for. Then I react to the shoryuken, I can ultra it. I did it kind of early. Like that. So you can, like, use that. You can use it to predict your opponent. That's not a super big risk to take. And leads to a pretty high payout. So that's one of the little tricks you can do to land it. But also, if the opponent's going to throw a fireball and you know they're going to throw a fireball, you teleport towards them. What's the better one to use? What, of teleports? I was doing kick teleport away, but I don't know if there's a big difference in that scenario. Wait, which is the better ultra to use? Oh, that's a hard question. You're not probably going to land either of them in most matches, so you might just pick Ultra Double just to take the first opportunity you can. Ultra 1 is better at chasing down teleports. It's better at punishing certain things. You can land an anti-air if you're good. Ultra 2 is next to impossible to land anti-air. Ultra 2 is invincible for a really long time, so you can use it to blow through a lot of things. And also, this is a big thing. This is a really big deal. Akuma likes to teleport away. And a lot of characters have, like, punishes for teleport. Like, let's say I'm fighting a Fei Long, and Fei Long sees my teleport, and he Rekka's after me. I can Ultra on reaction to his Rekka's and punish them. So you can use Ultra 2 to make yourself safe against a lot of punishes. Like, a really common one, actually, in this matchup, is if I see Akuma, like, teleport away on Wake Up, one thing that I would do is, do a teleport away on Wake Up for me. One thing that I would do is I would do a ultra to chase it down. And that'll punish it. That'll punish the teleport. So, Akuma, in return, if he sees someone, if he sees another Akuma, like, ultra one to chase down his teleport, he can ultra two cancel his teleport, and then, you know. Whoa. Oh, you gotta jump out of that. You can hold up, it's a throw. You're unthrowable during pre-jump frames. You can go straight from block stun to pre-jump frames. You gotta jump out of that. Anyway, try to teleport away on Wake Up. Whoa, get out of the way. Okay, cool. I'm trying to reaction ultra you. Reversal something. There you go. Now you can ultra. There you go. See that? You can use it to make your teleport safe. That's a really important thing. That's a big deal. Most characters don't have a reliable punish that will punish teleports and still be safe against Ultra 2. So that's one of the main uses of Ultra 2. You can use it to just teleport all the time. Run away Akuma's really strong. So every time you teleport away, you should churn a little bit of up. You know, just to be safe. And then if you see anything, you just tap 3 kicks. That's most of the Ultra setups I can think of. You can't land Ultra 2 after a focus attack. That's a pretty big deal. You have to do Stand Fierce or something, teleport cancel Ultra. You can't just do focus attack. Whoa, did I get it? Mid-air opponent? No. You can't just do it on a crumpling opponent. You actually can do teleport canceled ultra, like, without even a normal, because it's got a better hitbox. But you lose a lot of damage during that, so, you know, might as well do the fierce teleport cancel ultra. Add some damage back. Ultra 1 is really easy to land after a focus, though. You just hit the jabs while you're dashing in, and then back light kick hard punch when you get in. You can do it on reaction without too much difficulty if you're good with the motion. Give it a couple tries. What about Kara Super Ultra 1? Kara Ultra 1 is not that useful. It's good for the anti-airing purposes I was talking about. Kara Super is very useful, but your meter is better used elsewhere, so it's not as important as you would think. Most of Akuma's meter should probably be going towards Air EX Fireballs and Ground EX Fireballs and maybe EX Tatsus. And FADCs. FADCs are really important. It's good to stay safe. So because those things are all important, you really want to go for... you really probably won't usually have a super bar. Supers aren't that useful in this game, honestly. Oh, but check this out. Someone mentioned it earlier. Excuse me. It's good to know. Use a super real fast. There you go. Now look at your super bar, okay? You see that? Now check this out. Look at your super bar again. You get a lot of meter for eating a demon. And that's one of the downsides of landing demons. You're giving your opponent a lot of bar. And that's not a big deal if the opponent has full meter. But like, if the opponent doesn't have full meter, you better hope you're killing him, because he's going to have a lot of comeback potential. So that's one of the reasons people don't usually go for demon that much. So let's talk about a couple Akuma combos, I guess. And then we'll probably be done here. Confirm combos, yeah. You already seem to know. That's the bread and butter, Akuma confirm. Only works point blank. You can do combos that work outside point blank by doing short jab short, which pushes out less. Or short jab jab also works. Or, you know, just going for like combos that use hard Tatsu instead of light Tatsu, but usually you want light Tatsu. Nice little combo. Weird throw to go for there. This is a confirm combo, so this is how this works, if you don't already know, but I think you do. Hold down back. I'm just going for the string. If I react to the fact that you're blocking, I'm going to reset to a throw. And then I'm going to go for some kind of meaty shenanigans. If I react to the fact that I'm hitting you, I'm going to go for, like, a combo. And there's a lot of combos you can go for. So anyway, that's bread and butter confirm for Akuma. Short jab strong. You can go for, on a crouching opponent, if you happen to hit, you have to go for stand forward instead of low strong. And that's a hard thing to get into the reaction of doing, but at the same time, you usually won't be getting successful hits on crouching opponents. The only time I can think of is like if someone's committed to like a sweep or something and you jump in on them, you're going to be hitting them crouching. It's not a common thing, because when you do a focus, for example, the opponent's forced stand, and you're not going to be... After like a jump in, people probably aren't going to be... Maybe they'll like hold straight down. Like maybe if you do a cross-up and then like wait a second, then you crouch short, they'll like down back and then you'll counter hit their crouch short, so they'll be crouching, and then you'd have to go for like a combo like that. But that's the combo you do against crouching opponents. And then you can also do the same combo but cancel to a different special move, and that'll still pick up crouching opponents. And that combo is really good too, because on a cornered opponent, it'll, if you're cornered, it'll switch sides with you and the opponent. I don't know if this is universal. And then you can pick up an uppercut, actually. It's kind of cool. You see Tokido do that sometimes. It's a really cool looking combo. Or you can just go for EX Fireball. Also knocks down. Also works fine. What about Hard Punch? What is this? Hard Punch canceled to Quarter Circle Back Light Kick, DP plus Light Punch, FADC. Oh. That combo is not super useful anymore. That combo is not super useful anyway. It works, but it doesn't... It costs 2 bars and doesn't add a lot of damage. We were talking about that one earlier. And I'm fucking it up over and over. Just do it right. It's a lot of meter to burn for, like, what's, like, 60 extra damage. 2 bars for 60 damage, not that useful when you could be using your bar defensively. But if it kills, I did that combo backwards. I accidentally did Akuma's mechs. Max Dizzy. If that combo kills, power to you. Hold on. I'm an idiot. Let's say Crouch Fierce, Slight Tatsu, same Fierce, Slight Tatsu, Hard Uppercut. It's 290. Okay? Now let's compare this combo. It's 322. So you literally get 32 damage from burning two bars. Usually not worth it at all. That combo works, but I really don't recommend going forward or learning it. So that's confirmed combos in a nutshell. There's the Tokido one as well, which is low short, stand short, low strong. It's kind of a weird combo, but it's actually pretty good. That's a true block string too. That's the main appeal. It's a true block string that starts from a low that, well, low short, low jab is too. Setting opponents, you can do light punch, far stand, hard punch. That's kind of cool. That's a weird link. It's probably one frame, right? Oh, I got it. So yeah, Far Fierce cancels. Top 7 USF4 streamer, what does that mean? Yeah, it is a one frame link, confirmed. I'm trying to blink it, but it's hard. Oh yeah, I did mention this earlier, but just for a recap, Stand Fierce is actually optimal damage. It's getting kind of laggy here all of a sudden. That works even on crouching opponents, that link, but if you try and go into Tatsu, it'll fall out. I'm dropping it a lot. You have to go for Crouch Jab into Stand Fierce, and that's a two-frame link. I think after Stand Short, it doesn't combo. I think you don't get Close Fierce. Yeah, you get Far Fierce. What's with this lag all of a sudden? That's a bread and butter punish or confirmed combo for Akuma. Punish combos are much more straightforward. You just go for, like, let's say you block a Shoryuken, you probably go for, like, Crouch Fierce into Light Tatsu into Uppercut. Really straightforward combo. Just, you did it too early. You gotta wait for me to land. There you go. Yeah. Ish. That's something. You should learn to salvage that if that's what you get. Make sure you get the uppercut reliably on reaction. This is something you should definitely practice. Go into training mode, record a dummy. You can't do two lights into Akuma stand hard punch. Only Seth can do that. What are you talking about? I just did it. Anyway. That's not a one frame link, that's a two frame link. Close Fierce is faster than Fire Fierce. I can never plink that. Well, I promise it works. What were we talking about? Oh yeah, record a dummy to do light reversals and then block. Light sure you can block. And make sure you can reliably get a punish. This is super important. You're not gonna do too well if you can't get reliable punishes for Shoryukens. Remember to buffer the motion. Don't do Crouch Fierce, like, separately from Tatsu. You want to literally do a Tatsu, okay? Like, just down back light kick. Like, have that exact speed in your head. You want to do exactly that with a hard punch. Like, you want to have a hard punch somewhere in that motion when you're doing the down parts of it. But you want to do Tatsu exactly the same speed you do it when you're doing it by itself. You want to do, it's down... And then the hard punch. And then down, back, and then back, and then light kick. But that down, back, back is the exact speed when you're just doing Tatsu by itself. And you should get a real smooth Tatsu. Remember, there's no speed maximum, so just do it as fast as humanly possible, and it'll always work. But make sure you have this cancel really reliably. This is, I would call this an essential combo. An essential cancel. EX adds a little bit of damage. It's occasionally good to go for. It also goes farther. So sometimes, like, you can do a cross-up Tatsu and get them kind of far away. And then you can, if you do uppercut, it misses a hit. That time it didn't. That was pretty cool. But EX almost never misses a hit, so that's pretty nice. Forgot to mention that. EX is really reliable about getting all three hits. And it adds a little bit of damage, but it's not a whole lot, so, honestly. It's up to you whether you want to burn that bar or not. It's like 40 extra damage. It all depends on the scenario you're in. Not bad. Good combo. Do a light uppercut on me. I always walk in a little bit to help me time it. You can walk in after any, Oh, I'm dropping the Shoryuken. That's the easy part. You can walk in after any block, sure, you can. It's a habit that I picked up. EX sure you can actually goes... I don't know about Akuma's, because it doesn't go very far forward, but a lot of EX sure you can go really far forward. So I often... Akuma's almost never... Akuma doesn't have a whole lot of lateral movement. But against blocking like an EX sure you can, sometimes if I'm cornered, I'll do something like this. Do a block the EX sure you can on me. I'll like try and walk under it. Yeah, Akuma's you can't. Ryu's and Ken's, it's really easy, but I didn't think you could do Akuma's. I think you can do Sagat's purely by, like, just for the fact that he goes up really high. Akuma's got really good foot speed, by the way, so Akuma's tick-throw setups are really useful. You should know how to do that. You should be able to, like, you know, go for, like, block strings and stuff, and then just walk in and throw the opponent. Akuma's got a really good foot speed, and that's important for footsies. You can do three hits, and then, walk and throw and still get them pretty quickly. If you do a close, far stand hard kick, you can get stand hard punch instead of... Yeah, I mentioned that at the time. You can do stand hard kick into a close fierce. It's quite tight, though. Needs a very specific range. Whoa, oh, this is a thing. Check this out. Let's say you focus. Akuma's armor breakers, usually like EX Fireball, Hard Tatsu, I think. I don't know if Hard Tatsu works that well. It doesn't armor break. Officially, like Ryu's and Ken's do. Do a focus on me. Yeah, it doesn't actually armor break. It effectively armor breaks. And EX Fireball, same deal. But good luck if it's a red focus. But, Akuma's only actual armor break is the Demon Flip Palm. So usually you just want to teleport, get the fuck out of there. Something like this. Let's say you focus on me. I'm like, oh my god. That's nice and safe. Might not work in the corner. But if you have a focusing opponent and you do far hard kick, check this out. Focus on me. Far hard kick, it doesn't get the... It doesn't do any pushback on the first hit, so the second hit hits point blank reliably, and it often gets a counter hit. So it's really easy to pick up combos. So doing stand hard kick on a focusing opponent is a really good idea. Yeah, he's got far fierce in a combo. That doesn't work. You're pretty likely to get a counter hit here. The only way you can not get a counter hit is by, you're doing it too early, reliably too early. There it is. Nice pickup. The only way to not get a counter hit is if they backdash a second hit, which you can react to. Check it out. You didn't do fierce. It's quite hard to actually backdash a second hit. There, I did it. But that's the only escape left, and you're safe if they do that. So standard hard kick against a focusing opponent, really good idea. Standard hard kick is... A lot of characters can't crouch the second hit. So against those characters, standard hard kick is a really spammable poke. That you can just combo out of, theoretically, if you see it hit. Which I just dropped. Don't drop that combo. While the combo's to drop, don't drop that one. Just for the record, against fighting Akuma, if someone does light Tatsu into uppercut and they drop it, I tried to intentionally drop it and I failed. Always quick stand. Always quick stand. Because you can pick up a punish, yeah. And be aware that people will try and do that to you. And also, down back during combos in case he drops it, because if he drops a combo into Tatsu, you've got a very small amount of time to pick up the punish there. Usually you'd go for like crouch fierce or something. Or like stand fierce. You probably wouldn't normally go for a throw. I'm gonna try and... Yeah, just down back, and honestly, I'll just do the block string and I'll pretend. Too early. You want to react. That was too slow. You'll get good at this. Everyone gets good at this. A little early. That's a good option to go for, though. That's safe. I forgot to mention that. Hold on. Down back. EX Tatsu, it's like minus one. And it leaves you really far away from the opponent. So it's really safe to just go for. And one thing that's really good, like, let's say I'm going to throw you on wake up. Like, what are you going to do? Like, take the throw, right? That's all right. That's actually really interesting that you went for that. That's not what I was getting at. Let's say I throw you on wake up, and you wanted to take the throw or something, right? Yeah, like that. Now, let's do that again. Wait, hold on. No, after I knock you down. You see that? If you do a standing or a crouching tech, it loses to EX Tatsu. So EX Tatsu you can do a lot of times to catch people who are trying to be defensive. Like if I do this into throw, and I do this into EX Tatsu, it's like a mix-up. One of them is going to work. I don't know which one it is, but one of them will always work. Not necessarily always work. Someone could also mash out an uppercut. But, you know, it's a pretty solid mix-up between those two options. So EX Tatsu is really useful. You should use that move a lot. I'm really running out of things to talk about as Akuma. I think I've covered all his combos that are even remotely useful. I think I've... I don't know his setups at all, so I can't talk about those. I think I've talked in detail about all his special moves. So I think I have nothing more to say about Akuma. I hope this has been helpful for you. I have to get dedicate a lot of my time to it. And I am going to put it on YouTube if that's absolutely all right with you. And other people can learn Akuma, I suppose. For the record, you can increase punish combo damage just by going for F-ADC combos. So like maybe if I blocked a Shoryuken, I wouldn't necessarily do... Crouch Fierce into uppercut. Maybe I'll do like a combo with a fireball and then do an uppercut. And that'll add a lot of damage. There you go. That's kind of hard to do though. Yeah, that's what it looks like. You nearly had it. You were like on the edge. Hey, that was it. 3 hits. All you missed was the cancel on the second one. You'll get really good at this. One way to practice this, go to training mode, set the meter to infinite, and then just do it over and over. And then eventually you'll have a pretty nice little rhythm going. You'll know how to do it. Akuma doesn't have traditional super combos, so a lot of people just do this, burn 4 bars, do a 400 damage combo. It's like there you go, super combo. And you can mix and match all these different things to make big combos on a cornered opponent. For example, I would do something like this. I got the close fierce, but that's not what I wanted. What do I want? Okay, yeah. So I go for something like that. Drop combo. Far fierce. I'll do low strong. And I drop that. Oh my god. Combos are hard, dude. It's lagging for what it's worth, but I don't want to blame that fully on all my dropped combos. It's too far. Whoa, just too far in general. I was gonna do stay in roundhouse into low strong into fireball. FADC, Close Fierce, EX Tatsu, Shoryuken. But I can't seem to get even a small part of that. Even though it's not that hard of a combo. I'm like plinking it too, what's happening? I'm going too early and too late. And I'm often being out of range. It's a bit frustrating. I picked a weird combo. Let me just do something like this. Say I get a jump over a fireball on a cornered opponent. There you go. That's like a 463 damage combo. 3 bars. It's quite a lot. But the point is you can mix and match the different pieces of the combo. I'll take my word for it. That works, dude. What's happening? I picked up the link. I went just for the link. Good enough. You can also combo Light Tatsu to Hard Tatsu, but I'm pretty sure it's completely useless. But someone mentioned that earlier, and I just feel like saying it. Completely useless. It's cool looking. Far hard kick is punishable by command grabs by Geef and T-Hawk. Yeah, I did actually. It's like I'm pretty sure that's minus 2. And that grabblers can grab it. Yeah. There are a lot of characters you don't want to do it on. But like against like Abel, you can literally like spam the button. And Abel has a really hard time doing anything. For example. There are characters where you can just hit the button a lot. I'm pretty sure Abel doesn't duck under the second hit, and I know that Abel doesn't have a 2-frame move. That looks like some third strike shit. Third strike shit looks weird, dude. Don't just say that. When I think of third strike shit for Akuma, I think of Air Tatsu 1 hit, Ground Tatsu 3 hits, Air Tatsu 3 hits. That's what I think of. Oh yeah, you can be a Swagmaster if you want to. You can do combos like this. This combo's cool looking. Actually, I don't know if this works in this game. I'm trying to do Air Tatsu into Ground Tatsu. Yeah, it doesn't work in this game. I mean, that combo worked, but like on third strike, you can get 4 hits. You can do another Tatsu. You can do like 4 Tatsus. Or 3 Tatsus with 4 hits. It's cool looking. Not this game, though. I pretty much exhausted my Akuma knowledge off the top of my head. There's some other really random things I know about him, like other demon setups, but you've seen the demon video, right? I made a video called Raging Demon Encyclopedia, and it's got all the demon setups that I'm aware of. It's a pretty good watch, if you haven't seen it. If you don't know all the demon setups, you will. And I do it for all three characters. I do it for Akuma Ultra 1, I do it for Akuma Super, I do it for Evil Ryu Super, and I do it for Oni Super and Air Super. So just for a quick recap, maybe like Crouch Fierce into Light Tatsu into Shoryuken. Crouch Fierce because it forces stand, so it's more reliable as a punish tool. It's your punish combo. Maybe like low jab, short jab, strong into Tatsu, or like low strong, strong into Tatsu, or like strong fierce into Tatsu, something like that. It's your confirm combo. And then you can do like strong, strong, and then walk and throw if it doesn't work. Or like just strong, walk and throw. That works on everyone. I guarantee that works on everyone. I get that all the time. And then anti-airs, medium uppercut, hard uppercut, crutch fierce, more reliable, very fast. It's not more reliable, it's actually less reliable. It gets tattoos. That's one of the things about, like, if I were going to jump in and you were going to reversal uppercut, not reversal, but, you know, uppercut me, and I did tattoo, it would actually probably go over you. And crutch fierce will catch things that are going directly over Akuma, so that's good. Crutch fierce is reliable for going straight over Akuma's head. But uppercut does more damage, and it's got actual invincibility, and it comes out much faster. So, good to use. Throw a lot of air fireballs. Throw a lot of ground fireballs. Learn what the opponents can do to go through fireballs. Anti-air them. Try to bait and punish things. Try to run away. Try to be lame. That's all I can think of. That's Akuma in a nutshell. Pretty big nutshell, though. Like a walnut shell. Like a chestnut shell. So, I'm gonna go work on some videos. I hope I've helped you a bit, but we should play some mirror later on, Akuma Akuma, and see if we can dynamically help you in game, if you know what I mean. But if you want to practice some things in training mode, I would definitely practice those combos. Alright, see you later.